Well, hello everyone. It's good to see you guys back here again. Now today I wanted to talk to you guys about something called proportional control. So let's imagine that you have a machine that can change its output. Now this could be something as simple as a light bulb or a dimmer, or it could be a variable speed fan, or it could even be the engine in a car. Now you can change the output of these things manually. You can do that yourself, but if you want these machines to be operated automatically, you have to have some means of regulating their output. And proportional control is one of the simplest ways to do this. So let's imagine that, say, you had a variable speed fan and you wanted this fan to cool a certain object to a certain temperature and maintain it there. Or let's say you wanted to use like cruise control in a car and you wanted the engine in that car to maintain the vehicle at a certain speed. Proportional control is just one of many ways to do this, but it's one of the simpler ones. So in order for proportional control to work, we really only need three things. We need something called the set point, and sticking with our cruise control example, the set point in this case would be how fast you actually want the car to travel. The next thing that we would need is the process variable, and in this case that would be how fast the vehicle is actually traveling, and of course we need a sensor to actually detect this. Finally, the third thing that we need is called the error, and this is where the name proportional control actually comes from, because the control output is proportional to the error. So getting the error is actually really easy to do. The only thing that you need to do is take the set point, subtract the process variable, and there you are at the error. So for example, if you wanted to drive your car at 60 miles an hour and it's actually going 55, you would take 60 miles an hour, subtract 55, and there you are. You have a 5 mile an hour error. And again, it's called proportional control because the output is actually proportional to the error. So as you can see, if the vehicle were to slow down, the more it would slow down, the further away it would get from that set point, the higher the engine's output would be. And for the most part, it's just that simple. In some cases, the error may actually not be enough to get the machine to produce enough output to keep it close enough to the set point. In this case, there's something added called proportional gain. Now, gain is actually something that's either added or multiplied onto the error to make the error large enough to get the machine to keep its output up. And that's pretty much all the explanation you need to know about proportional gain. That's pretty much all it does. It's just added onto the error. Okay, so I've prepared an example for us to all, so we can all see proportional control in action here. Now, it's actually quite simple. You see that I've got the flashlight there, and it's laying with its face on the ground, and underneath it, you see those wires there. Underneath that flashlight, there's a temperature sensor that goes into the Arduino. Now, the Arduino is now loaded with the proportional control software that I've written for this demonstration, and on the oscilloscope, you can see the output of the Arduino's pulse width modulator. Again, this is running from proportional control software. And on the computer here, you can see that I have the actual air temperature, in this case as a process variable. That's what the sensor is actually reading. The target air temperature would be the set point, so I've set it to 78, and then I have the proportional gain programmed in too. And again, as you can see, those are actually really close, so that means the output right now is actually very low. So yeah, on the oscilloscope here, this represents on the bottom the time that it's off, and in the top the time that it's on. So you can see it's not very on for a very long time. That's because we're close, and like I said, the output's actually proportional to the error. So what I'm going to do, so we can see this on camera here, I'm going to go ahead and increase that target temperature, and we'll see how well that can actually follow it. I'm going to turn it up. Let's turn it up to. We're going to turn it up to. I'm going to turn it up to 90. That's like what? 32 Celsius, something like that, for all you guys not in the US here. And I don't know if you can see this on camera. Those pulses actually have gotten a little bit wider, so the output actually is higher. And we'll go back to the computer really quick, and you can see it is coming up. But like I said, the error may actually not be enough for it to get to its set point. Looks like it's still coming up. So that's why I added in the proportional gain to the software. So if need be, I can actually change the proportional gain. Well, let me show you here. I can turn the proportional gain up. And in this software, the proportional gain is actually just added to the error. Now, in some software, it works a little bit different, but In my software, I just made an add-on to the error, and you can see now that I've increased the proportional gain. It's getting up to the set point a little bit faster. It'll take it a while for it to get there. Let me pause the camera, and I'll show you what it does when it gets there. Alright, so this is what I wanted to show you guys right here. With proportional control, there's always some error. That's the nature of it. Because the machine output is determined from the error, if there were no error at all, the machine would actually shut down. So with proportional control, you're either always going to go above the set point or you're going to be slightly below the set point. Now, normally this is not that big of a deal for most applications. Like, let's say for if this was an actual thermostat for an actual house and we had some kind of heater that could change its output, like modulating heater, right? Now, normally I think this would be pretty acceptable. You know, if you wanted it to be 90 degrees, I don't know why you'd want that, but if you did, 89 I think would be good enough. But in some applications, you actually can't use proportional control. But anyway, in case I didn't make this clear, yes, the Arduino is actually controlling the flashlight. And so the flashlight just heats the temperature sensor, the Arduino reads it, and if the temperature is too low, it increases the output, and if it gets too high, it decreases the output with proportional control. So, hope that made sense, guys. Now, as I just said, there are some drawbacks to proportional control. And the main one is that there's always going to be an error. That is, there's always going to be a difference between the set point value and the process variable. So if you were using it in, say, a car for cruise control, you'd never actually quite get to your set point, or you might go above it. So proportional control is not suitable for applications where high precision is required. For most other ones, it actually works reasonably well. Now the other thing is, increasing the proportional gain, as you saw, caused it to react faster, but it could also cause it to overshoot the target temperature and then start oscillating, that is, go above and then below and keep repeating that pattern over and over again. If the proportional gain is too low, it may actually never get to the set point or it'll just come up really slowly. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you understood all that simple explanation. Next video, I might try a PI to explain PI control, but we'll get into that one a little bit later. It was good to see you guys, and I hope to see you guys again soon. Take care.